Hello students, in our last video we have discussed about two dimensional array, why it is called array of arrays, why it is called matrices, and how we declare the two dimensional array, how we represent the blocks of the arrays, or you can say how we give the index number of the arrays, right? So now we will look how we initialize the array, okay? Initialize means how we enter the elements in the array. So if you can recall, in one dimensional array we used a loop, right? When you are dynamically entering an array, we used a loop. So that loop, how many loops are there? Only a single loop we have run, right, by using the counter I. Okay, so here, see, first we'll obviously we have to declare the array. So array will be of type data type int, name will be arr, and it will have 3, as in the last video I've discussed. These 3 represent what? These 3 represent number of rows, and this 5 represent number of columns. So you can say it is representing this array, okay, this matrix or array it is representing. Now see, for one dimensional array we have taken only I as the counter, but here we are taking 2 counters, that is I and j. That means what? We have to run 2 loops, okay, we have to run 2 loops. Now see, now you can ask why we have to run 2 loops. So see, by first loop, the first loop will run from I equal to 0, I less than 3, I plus plus. That means I is representing what? I is representing the rows, right? I is representing the rows. That means I is representing this value of every index. I is representing this value of every index, right? I is representing the value of every index. But there is another value that we need to represent, isn't it? There is any value that we need to represent. What is it? The value of the column. So if I is representing the value of row, there should be some loop to represent the value of column, right? Or we cannot indicate every index by individually, so we have to represent this also. So for that, for the column, representing column, which another loop we have to run with counter j, all right? So that will run from, j will run from 0 to less than 5, that is 0 to 4, which will represent the column, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright. Now see another thing. You can ask why this loop, which is representing column, is inside this loop, which is representing row. Right. So it is inside because the loop that is representing row has just started here but not closed yet. That means it is inside this loop, that is we can call it as a nested loop, right? So why it is inside? Because look here, when I is indicating this, right, so when the row will change after it complete all entering the elements in all the columns, isn't it? When this, say if it is row is in 0, if the pointer is in 0, when will it come to 1? It will come to row 1 only after all the elements in the all the columns has entered. That means when this element is entered, this column it is filled, 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 after that it will come to the next row, isn't it? Similarly, when this all these columns will be completed, after that only it will come to the next row, right? So that means what? Inside every row, all the columns are filled, means filled. After that, it will come to the next row. Again, all the columns will be filled. After that, it will come to the next row. Again, all the columns will be filled. That means it is happening inside the row only. That's why the column loop that is representing the column is inside the loop that is representing the row. And always remember, first which loop will run? The row. First we have to write the loop for the row. Alright, we cannot interchange this, because why? In the last video we have discussed two dimensional array or matrix, or in matrix first we represent it by rows, then only we will represent it by columns, that is rows cross columns. So same here. So first we will represent row, then it is column. Alright, so I guess you have understood why it is going this way, because see, for example, now, okay, so let's see next. So if you are using C++, you know how we take input, right? So I think it's an error, so it will be not C out, it will be C in, right? So if you are in C++, you have to write what? C in, then a name of the array, and inside that what will write? C. Or if you are C, you are doing in C programming, you have to write scanf, then %d, then and array name, after that C, for both C++ and C programming. C inside first what we have written? I. Why? Because I is representing the array. So when I is 0, that means it will be either here or here. Okay, so I is representing the row, right? So either when I is 0, it will be representing the first column, first row, right? So first row will come, then column we know. That's why it is represented this way. Okay, so now let's see, for example, say I is 0 at the beginning, right? So it will, is 0 less than 3? Yes, 0 less than 3. It will enter where? In this loop. Again, it will see a loop is going on, that is j is equal to 0. Yes, j is equal to 0. So is 0 less than 5? Yes, 0 less than 5, then it will go to this line. Okay, so it will enter the element where arr 0 0. So 0 0 means it is represented the first index, right? Next, what will happen? Which one will be increment, this or this? So this will be 0 0. So which one will be increment, this or this? Obviously this, because it is inside the loop, right? Because it is inside the loop, that's why which one will increase? This will be incremented, that is j plus plus. J plus plus means 1. So I value is 0, now j value is 1. 1 is less than 5, correct? So next element will be entered where? Next element will be entered, I value is 0 and j value is 1, that is in this position next value will enter, right? Then again j will be incremented, not I, j, because this loop, we are not out of this loop yet, right? Now value of j becomes 2 and I remains 0. So next element will be entered in 0 2, that is 0 2 is here. So similarly it will go on up to 4. So when this becomes 5, means when elements enter here, what will happen? This loop will be completed, that means it will go where? I will be incremented, I becomes 1, right? Now I value is 1. Is 1 less than 3? Yes, it will come here. Again, j will start from the initial value, that is j equal to 0. So I value is 1 and j value is 0, that is in 10 position it will enter, right? Next, again j will be incremented. When j is incremented, that means what? J becomes 1 now. So next value is entered in 11, alright, because I remains 1 only. So similarly, all these elements will be entered. After that, again I will be incremented, I will become 2, again j becomes 0. From 0, again all these elements will be entered, and after that it is completed, right? I guess you have understood it. If you have doubt, you can ask. So in our next video we will see a program where we will enter the elements, okay? So thank you.